The following is a series of exercises that can be used as a form of home-based vestibular therapy. The exercises begin with small, slow movements and graduate to larger, faster movements. Each movement should be completed 20 times each. Each of these movements can also be made more difficult by closing the eyes or by shaking the head like you're saying no. The first set of exercises are to be completed while sitting. The individual will keep their head still and slowly begin to look up and down while getting quicker as they go. Then eye movements back and forth should be completed. Try and focus on an object of each end of the eye jump. Now the eyes will remain focused forward while the head moves. First, move the head up and down. Then, still keeping the eyes forward, they will move their head right and left. Lastly, the head and the eyes will be moving. With the eyes open, the individual will nod their head up and down. The eyes should follow the direction of the head movement, initially slowly and then getting faster. Lastly, the head will be turned from right to left. Next, still sitting, the individual will take their finger or a pen and hold it about 1 foot in front of their face. Then they'll extend their arm all the way out in front of them. This in and out movement will be repeated 20 times while the individual watches the tip of the finger or object. The head should not be moving, just the arms and the eyes. While sitting, the individual will slowly shrug and roll their shoulders backwards 10 times. Then they'll roll their shoulders forward 10 times. Find a light, graspable object like a tennis ball or balled up pair of socks. I will be using a small child's ring. While sitting, bend forward and lay the object on the ground, and then pick the object back up. Sitting fully up between each movement, maintain eye gaze on the object as you move. Complete 10 times with the right arm, and then 10 times with the left arm. Now practice going from a sitting position to a standing position, then back to a sitting position, 20 times. If you need to hold on to the handles of the chair, that is fine as well. With the same object used before for picking up from the ground, now you will throw the object from hand to hand. The object should be thrown above eye level. If the object falls, pick it back up and continue. This condition should be completed while sitting at first. Once mastered, the individual can do the same exercise while standing. The last exercises are to be completed while standing. Be sure to wear flat shoes with a back strap, such as tennis shoes, or do this barefoot. A heeled shoe, sandal, or slipper is not appropriate. In a corner for safety, stand with your feet shoulder-width apart and your eyes open. The chin should be up and the eyes facing forward. Arms should be by the side unless an unsteadiness is felt, and then the individual can catch themselves on the wall. Once comfortable, the eyes can be closed for 30 seconds at a time. It is okay if the ankles begin to sway. Open the eyes and begin to do ankle sways, rocking back and forth from your toes to your heels. Try not to bend at the hip or look down at the feet. Keep the chin up and the eyes forward. Next, the individual will attempt standing on a soft, compressible surface, such as a pillow or a folded blanket. The feet should be hip-width apart, arms down at the side unless needed to regain stability. Stand for 30 seconds on the soft compressible surface with the eyes open, and then 30 seconds with the eyes closed. Now begin to shake the head back and forth for 30 seconds. Continue to shake the head with the eyes open and then with the eyes closed. Opening the eyes, now a stepping procedure can be completed on the soft surface. Shift weight from one foot to another, first with the eyes open and then with the eyes closed. Do this for 30 seconds each. Back onto a firm surface, practice walking forward 10 steps and then walking backwards for 10 steps. If you have stairs, you can practice walking up and down the stairs. Lastly, try dancing carefully with a partner, performing frequent turns. Any activity involving stooping or turning is generally good.